Mangalorean cuisine has evolved over the years to include different ethnicities like Muslims, Mangalorean Catholics, Saraswath Brahmins, and Bunts, to name a few. Since Mangalore is a coastal city, fish forms the staple diet of most people, and Mangalorean cuisine is generally spicy and rice-based. Karishma took us to an old classic restaurant, Maharaja, to try some authentic Mangalorean delicacies like Kori rutti, chicken ghee roast, Neer dosa, and shellfish.
So this is shellfish, marwai sukka.
Marwai sukka?
Yeah, marwai sukka. Sukka means dry.
Yeah, sukha means dry. Sukka, yeah,
sukka. Sukka. We call it sukka. And this is Neer dosa. Neer dosa means, in Tulu, it is Neer means water. This is ghee roast.
That's ghee roast?
Yeah. There's a lot of ghee, masala ghee. And this is the gravy, normal chicken gravy. So this is spread over the roti to make it soft, and then we have it. This is Kori roti.
That's made up of rice?
Yeah, they're made up of boiled rice. Once the gravy makes it soft, that means it is absorbed.
Yeah.
It's ready to eat now.
This is something which you make at home as well?
Rutti we can't prepare.
Okay.
Because the style of preparation is different. Mm-hmm. But it is available in every grocery shop.
Mm-hmm.
Wherever you ask for rutti, it is available. Mm-hmm.
And you can eat with any curry?
Huh.
Or normally chicken you eat it with?
We usually eat it with chicken. That's why it's called as Kori rutti.
Mm-hmm.
Kori means chicken in
Tulu. I can taste ghee also in it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Maybe for taste they'll add some.
Mm-hmm. And this chicken has lots of curry leaves.
Mm, yeah.
There's curry leaves also in it.
Curry leaves use a lot of flavor.
Yeah, let's try some with the chicken. Mm. And lots of garlic also in it.
Yeah.
And the curry.
Yeah, curry.
Got lots of garlic taste. It's not spicy.
Mm.
The shellfish. Mm. I'm not good at eating seafood, so you can tell me how to eat this. That's it. That's a shellfish.
Just tilt it around.
Mm-hmm. Huh.
And just remove this, yeah.
Like this?
Yes, exactly.
With the thumb?
Mm, yeah, with thumb.
There's lots of ginger and garlic in it.
Mm-hmm.
And this is more like a starter. You don't eat it with any bread or just on its own?
It's like,
yeah,
like a starter.
Mm-hmm. So curry leaves is used in everything,
mm-hmm,
in all the preparation.
Yes.
It's quite red in color.
Yeah.
You can see the chicken.
And with a lot of ghee.
Yeah, and lots of ghee. It loads of ghee in it, although it looks bright red in color,
yeah,
but it's not spicy,
not
at,
spicy
all.
At all.
Yeah.
It's only because of that long chili.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
You like the fish?
Amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. So Mangalore is like known for chicken ghee roast.
Yeah, mm. Mangalore, especially this restaurant, mm, is very famous for ghee roast.
Mm-hmm.
Ghee roast, it's available everywhere, but you won't get that proper taste.
Mm-hmm.
I can say this is the proper taste of,
mm-hmm,
ghee roast.
So you're telling us about Neer dosa.
Mm.
So basically the word Neer itself means water.
Water, yeah.
That's why they call it, it's white in color. That's why they have named it, mm, Neer dosa.
Like we make batter using rice, only,
mm-hmm,
rice.
Mm-hmm.
And we add lot of water,
mm-hmm,
until it is very thin.
Mm-hmm.
So that it is easy to
make it
all over the pan.
Yeah.
How thin you make it,
mm-hmm,
that good you feel good while eating.
Mm-hmm. So whatever we have tried, it's super delicious.
Yeah.
Everything is like I'm trying for the first time. The first time I tried the Neer dosa, the Kori roti, chicken ghee roast, shellfish, and with the curry.
Yeah.
Everything is like full of flavors. And I really like the way like the, this roti, now it's become so soft.
Yeah.
So you add curry over it, it makes it more soft.
The
curry is like absorbed by this bread, this roti, and you get a nice texture to it. Oh, that was a great meal.
Yeah, I'm glad that you guys enjoyed it. So let's try out our next thing.
Yeah.
One of the city's most popular go-to spots for authentic Mangalorean cuisine is Giri Manjas. This nondescript eatery is tucked away in Mangalore's Kar Street.
So we are in MPT Road now, and right in front of Giri Manjas, an iconic place where you can try seafood.
Seafood?
Yeah.
Oh,
fish fry and all that.
Yeah, this is like one place recommended by everyone.
Yes.
Giri Manjas.
Exactly.
So finally we are at Giri Manjas.
Yes.
Like, this is an iconic shop in Mangalore, and if you ask any local, they would recommend you one place to eat, that is Giri Manjas. And they are known for seafood.
Very famous.
So what are we going to try here?
So today we'll be trying prawns and squid, also a meal.
Okay.
Fish meal.
Fish meal with prawn fry and squid.
And squid fry, oh. Also a fish fry.
Oh, I'm really excited to try it. That's red in color.
Yeah.
That's kokum. I've never tried the rice with kokum. And then we have cauliflower, green peas.
This is very famous. We call it as the manuli kadle.
It seems kundru.
Yes, kundru and black chana.
Banana.
Banana.
Pickles, papar, and
this
the
fish.
Fish.
We call it as bangure fish.
Bangure fish. Sear fish. In
Tulu we call it as anjal.
Anjal.
Anjal fry. And this is bondas.
Bondas.
Yes, bondas fry.
Bondas fry, anjal fry. That's the prawn fry. And now we have lime and coconut.
Coconut, yeah. Bonda. Bonda and lime.
Bonda and
coconut
lime.
Coconut is called as bonda.
Yeah. Mm. What should we try first? Yes. Should we try the prawn? Oh, you can see like it's like a lot of spices in it. It's quite crisp in texture. And then they've given you a red chili, sorry, green chili with it. Mm.
Very fresh.
It's fresh and crisp also. And now we have squid.
Yeah, they have applied some masala. And then deep fried. You can also prepare a sukka. Prawn sukka, like in Mangalore style. Mm-hmm. Or gravy. Different ways you can prepare them.
In sukka you will add like lots of ginger, garlic,
coconut
in it. Wow. This is the sear fish. There's like a whole layer of spices over it.
Yeah. And this taste you won't get anywhere. Oh. So this is special only in Giri Manjas. Mm. They are special way of frying.
It's quite tangy. The masala tangy, is quite
yeah.
tangy. Oh, let's have it. So it's like they do marinate the fish first.
Yes.
And then fried.
So that they reach till
yeah, so
like entire fish being absorbed by yeah. all masala.
And the spices, the masala is completely different. Which spices
yeah,
they have used?
Different. Mm. This is their secret, you know, they don't reveal.
Wow. And you can try it with the rice as well?
Yeah, yes.
Mm. So Mangalore is a place for seafood.
Yes.
If you want to try the best seafood, you have to come
Mangalore.
To Mangalore,
yeah. No doubt. Mm. We feel like they might have a little bit of coconut. We're not sure, but because of this texture, we feel that maybe there's a presence of coconut.
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 Yeah.
No.
We guess, we are not sure.
So no one knows like what the recipe is. It's still a secret recipe. So everything we tried was super delicious, and I really like the interior of this place. It feels like you're eating at a home.
Yeah. They haven't changed anything. They've retained every thing of it.
Yeah.
So that's something good about this place.
So it feels like you're having the food at home.
Oh.
And the spices and everything is quite perfectly balanced. I really like the sear fish. It was again super delicious. Like tawa fried, you get a nice flavor of ghee in it. Then the prawns, perfect crispy prawns you have.
Very tender.
Yeah, very tender, and the squid as well. And this is a new combination which I've tried for the first time. Boiled rice with kokum. That was a great meal.
I hope you enjoyed it.
I loved everything. I loved sear fish. I loved the golden fried prawns. Everything was super delicious.
Like, because of that freshness, you know, everybody will fall in love. That's why, you know, can never be replaced. They are always the best.
Let's go to next place.
Yeah, sure.
For the evening snacks, Karishma took us to another local eatery, Karthik Hotel.
So now we are at Hotel Karthik. Let's try some Mangalore snacks like Mangalore buns, then banana kori, then KT chai and goli bhaji.
Yeah. So this is Kashi Halwa.
This is Kashi Halwa.
What's that?
Avlaki. And that is onion pakoda.
Onion pakoda, onion bhaji.
Onion bhaji. This is goli bhaji.
Oh, this is goli bhaji.
Yes, this is goli bhaji.
And this?
That is banana podi.
Banana podi. And this?
This is alu ka vada.
Alu vada.
Here we ordered the famous Kalada tea, also known as KT. A three-layer tea where the bottom layer is the condensed milk, layer above is the foam, and on top goes the decoction.
is banana puri.
There's a banana in it. And over it like besan, chickpea flour.
Yes. And the second one is Mangalore buns.
Mangalore buns?
Yes. So this is made up of maida to which a lot of banana is added so that you get the flavor and the softness.
Ripened banana?
Ripened banana.
Okay.
Well, kneading the dough, there are a lot of banana.
And then you have sambar?
Sambar and
coconut chutney.
Yes. And this is goli bhaje.
That's goli bhaje?
Yes. In Mangalore we call it by name goli bhaje.
We have coconut also in it?
Yes. Sometimes there are coconut. Chili. And it's made up of maida. There is also ginger. Wow. Ginger added for increasing the flavor.
And they're soft also, fennel seeds.
They're very soft.
Wow. That's again very soft and spongy. Is that just maida?
It's made up of maida. Oh. They add curd.
Oh, curry leaves also. No, green chilies.
Green
chili. Oh, there's a green chili inside it. The green chili, fennel seeds, curry leaves. Let's try it. Mmm. Wow, that's really good. Very light.
No, that crispy layer is very tasty.
It's very light. I was thinking it to be a bit deep fried, so it would be a bit heavy, but it's very light. And the fennel seeds gives a nice taste to it. Isn't I very excited to try this one?
Yeah.
I was thinking it's like so soft and spongy. And you said like it's mix of maida,
yes.
This is white flour with banana.
Yeah.
Let's try it out. Oh. Again, you can see the fennel seeds in it.
Yeah. Not necessary.
Mmm. Wow, so fresh.
It's very common and it's available in every restaurant.
Yeah.
Mangalore buns and goli bhaje.
Mm. This is very good. The sambar is sweet.
Yeah. They add jaggery to it.
In sambar?
Yeah.
This is like they call it when the sambar is sweet, it's Udupi style, is it?
Yeah. Mm. Here, normally we add sweet to some bhaji also, like for beef bhaji, we add a little bit of sugar to increase the taste.
Yeah. So I love this bun. It's so soft and you can have it on its own. You don't need sambar or chutney with it.
Anything.
You can have it with a cup of tea. It's a good snack. The tea which we are having is called Keti.
Keti.
Which is like just a three-layered tea. At the bottom is milk, then you have decoction, and then you have milk foam. It's a very simple thing.
Yourself.
Yeah, it's a very simple thing. Simple to make. You just add milk and then you have to add foam and then slowly you pour. But the catch is that the milk should be the sugar. Without sugar, you won't get it.
It gets mixed.
Let's have it. Like I could try it with the tea, the Mangalore buns with the tea. Mmm. And now we have banana puri.
Yeah, banana puri.
Wow, it was great trying the Mangalore buns. I loved it. And also the goli bhaje.
Yeah.
Not goli bhaji, goli bhaje.
Next, Karishma introduced us to Halli Manne Roti, a mobile fast food joint that serves North Karnataka delicacies. The food joint offers three types of rotis made up of ragi, jowar, and rice.
So we are at Gandhinagar now. So I've come here to try different types of rotis at Halli Manne Roti.
Halli Manne?
Yes, Halli Manne Roti. Halli Manne in the sense the village house rotis.
Oh.
It's a typical ancient type.
So it's like village food?
Yes, village food.
This is the place where we are going to try three different kinds of roti. Not roti. Rotis. One is made up of rice flour, second is jowar, and third is ragi. And that's the machine, how they make it. Wow, here they have two different kinds of roti. This is jowar roti, that's...
And that is rice.
Oh, so that's akki roti, that's rice
akki roti.
Very famous here. And then you have jola roti.
Jola roti.
That's basically jowar roti.
Jowar roti.
We call it shorgam roti.
Okay.
Yeah. This is like considered to be very healthy.
Very healthy.
Very healthy.
So it's been made flattened over there. Just like
fulka. Yeah, just like fulka. It's like a good fulka, like it's healthy fulka. And jowar roti is, jowar is also considered to be like gluten free. So it's good for health. So, we have three different kinds of bread here.
Yes. Jowar, ragi, and then rice.
And then it is served with...
This is some curry. Okay. Mixed vegetable curry.
And then it's served with a drink. What is it called?
In our language, we tell it as Punarpuli juice.
Punarpuli?
Puli, yes.
Digestion.
Yeah.
Good for digestion.
Oh. Sweet.
Sweet, yeah.
Wow, it's very sweet. Let's try the rotis. It's quite healthy, like jowar, ragi is considered very healthy. And it's served with this sabji. Let's have ragi.
Served hot.
Yeah. This ragi roti with some chutney. Ragi considered to be very healthy. It's very high in fiber,
yeah.
Very nutritious. And it's like a food of rural Karnataka. And that's the akki roti, that's rice
akki roti.
That's very soft roti. And let's try with the chutney. Oh, so now we are going to try it with chicken curry. It smells so nice, like it's lots of black pepper in it.
Yeah.
It's completely different. Oh.
Hot and good.
It's quite thick gravy compared to other places. It's quite thick. And it's lot of pepper in it.
Goes well with
the
rice roti,
which is a bit thick. The best part, like we have been to many places in Karnataka already, the food is not oily here.
Yeah.
Where we went to, it's not like the oil is floating on the top. Even chicken curry is so light.
Yeah. The woman herself started this
place.
This
place? Yes. Only in the evening time the shop opens up.
Only in the evening.
No.
Even she doesn't share her recipe.
No.
And she personally go to market, collect the ingredients and do it at her home till afternoon and then get it here.
I loved it. It feels so healthy.
Yeah.
Like whatever we have tried here, the ragi roti, akki roti, jowar roti, then potato curry, green chili, chutney and chicken curry. All of them, like it feels healthy, like having healthy stuff. And then you end with a coconut drink.
Punarpuli juice.
Opposite Kadri Park in Mangalore is a food street where you can try pani puri and other street dishes.
So what are you going to try here?
We can try charmuri.
Charmuri?
Yeah, we'll try charmuri.
What is charmuri?
Charmuri is puffed rice.
Puffed rice?
Yeah.
Okay.
Puffed rice.
Like bhel puri? Similar to bhel puri.
Mixed with all masalas like and also mango pieces.
Okay.
For that tanginess.
Let's try it out.
Overall, good.
Let's try it out. Muri is basically muri means puff rice.
Okay.
Murmure or muri means puff rice. So I think that's the how it is derived from that name, muri.
Yeah,
charmuri. In Bihar, they call it muri, puff rice. So, ek plate bana dijiye. Carrot. Mango, haan. Bina chile hue. You can't peel it off.
Directly,
without even peeling it off, you simply grate it. That's peanuts, coconut oil. See, like it's very similar. Like there, they add mustard oil, here, the peanut, coconut oil, red chilies. That's what we call murmure, muri, or what do you call it in local language? What do you call it?
Kurlu.
So every place has a different snack, like a street snack. Very nice. So good. It's a healthy snack. And it's like just puff rice, some grated carrot, onion, raw mango, peanuts, coconut oil, spices, red chili and salt, that's it. So it's a bit sweet, spicy, tangy, all different flavors.
Yeah. This carrot will give a little bit of sweetness.
Mm-hmm.
When mangoes are not available off season, they add lemon.
Lemon in it?
Yeah. So that tangy flavor.
Mm-hmm.
But since now mangoes are available, they're using
that. Mm. Yeah. Back at home, normally we add lemon. And we add mustard oil. Raw mustard oil, we don't add coconut, we don't use much coconut oil in cooking. So we use a lot of mustard oil. So we'll add some chana, muri, that's puffed rice, onion, sometimes tomato, okay, sometimes sprouts as well. And then mustard oil mixed with the spices and lemon. Wow.
We also had grape juice at the local hangout place, Dinky Dine.
Grape juice. Healthy drink. It's very refreshing.
And that's enjoyment when you get the pulp.
You get the pulp of the grapes.
Normally the place will be very crowded, like in the morning and the evening, because you get everything, breakfast, the proper lunch, everything. There's Kadri Park nearby, very famous park. People come for a walk, or in the evening they come for just spending some time. They come here and try this drink, which is very refreshing.
We ended our Mangalore food journey at the iconic ice cream shop Pabas.
So our Mangalore food tour has come to an end. So we are ending it with a sweet note. We have come to a very famous spot. It's like a mandatory place where you have to come and have ice cream, Pabas. So let's go and have it.
So we'll end our food journey at the ice cream parlor. It's like you're having a real paan.
Exactly.
Really good. With mint in it. Yeah. You can taste mint. I'm a big fan of paan. I love
this
chewing paan. And you have fennel seeds, mint, all different sweet paan flavors. Then you have cherry. And this is like something, I think that's why they have named it marzi paan. Because yeah, marzi paan is like a barfi. That's why. The covering is something very similar to that. Wow. What is this one? This looks tempting. Gadbad.
Yes. This is butterscotch. After that you have a layer. This is basically of a strawberry, which has jelly. This jelly you can see. And also like semia. The ghee semia.
Faluda.
Faluda, yeah. That. And then you have a fruit layer. The bottom is vanilla.
Oh, so you have vanilla, strawberry and butterscotch with cherries and fruits.
Yeah.
Let's try it. You have to mix all of them together?
Yeah, together.
Oh, so you get the flavor of all the ice creams. It's very good. It's a fruits and you have dry fruits as well.
Yeah.
Both of them. Wow. That's the fruit.
Proper, complete mixture.
Yeah. Very good banana. The banana fruit. No, it's really good. With this, our food journey in Mangalore comes to an end. And we really had great time exploring the local delicacies here. I really liked the ghee roast, the Kori roti, and the food at Giri Manja. It was super delicious. So thank you so much for taking our time and showing us a beautiful city.
Glad that you came and you enjoyed our cuisines. Thank you so much.
Thank you.